Southwest leading also in Chuck.
Check this, please, John.
Let's see anyone?
Let's see.
Lights up, needle power. Clear me left.
Clear left.
Okay, a couple miles behind you, right? Okay.
Nobody's fishing.
Needle power set.
Up.
Hotel 100 on Foxtrot, say it again. Skyman 504 Foxtrot, see you next on the column, Christian 18-9000, we expect more passing off the direction traffic of PD-31 at 8000 and also a PD-31.
And Reeve 186, we're off at 1621.
Did she say Roger? Is that kind of listening to him? I think so.
And another one.
I'll listen to him. Now, what I was wondering about is that guy said something about he could maintain visual with Reeve or maintain something with Reeve was talking about.
He took off the VFR and he's trying to pick up flight plan.
Well, I know that, but when he's way ahead of us, he doesn't even know where we are. What was he talking about in reference to us?
I don't know, maybe he's still on
Probably even steer around a little bit and go around, but keep going through that if you could, Jim. Whatever
it takes. Echo 544 Alpha Lima, I don't have a flight plan in the system on you. Stand by, I'll take you over the air.
Scared.
Huh?
I just wanted a chance to meet you, John. Well, she's sitting with the boyfriend. Husband.
Brother?
Yeah.
Out of 10.
Out of 10.
Ice water, please.
And ice water for me. So what are we going to try to get ourselves in?
Vessel 41 Anchorage Center, maintain 6,000 until 7 miles west of Kodiak, establish southbound on Victor 506, and climb and maintain 16,000.
So much further than that, he's going to start calling
you
off course.
We're almost close to 4 miles.
Foxtrot here, so do you need to know at the Kodiak?
That guy didn't get our spot anyway.
7 4 Foxtrot Sierra, descend and maintain 8,000, report passing 20 miles north of Kodiak.
Northeast,
5-4-4 Alpha Lima Ritter contact northeast of Dillingham, 71 miles to the Anchorage Airport by direct climb, maintain south of the 250.
Alpha Lima cleared Anchorage direct up to 250.
can't test pass.
So it's okay. It's okay.
Yeah. It depends upon the transponder.
It gets slower when you can get it.
That comes from the other airplane. And see, it receives that signal and is able to display the relative position. And then if that airplane has altitude reporting, then it can show whether the airplane is climbing or descending and how much difference between that airplane and us where we're at.
But it
if the airplane doesn't have a transponder, then GCAS doesn't see the airplane.
That's dangerous. That's, I think, what happened in India, right? Between Saudi Arabia and the Russian airplane. They didn't know that they were there.
Well, the Russian airplane didn't have the transponder. That's true. It's not really a radar. What it is, it's just a receiver.
Yeah.
on his clear so he can transfer.
Minutes.
got it inside at the time.
Here. Green, right out from this live cross-tech.
Cox 100, go.
Okay, turning down to 100.
Alaska rolling pits, there should be no factor. Below the Vazis coming up on a mouse.
Thank you very much, gentlemen.
Yeah. Well, tomorrow is Russia for me.
For you? With Electra? To Providinia?
Providinia Bay.
Oh, you're lucky.
Yeah, I know, I get all the luck.
With this one, right?
Probably this one, yes.
You fly 2.5 hours?
About 2.5 hours each way, yes.
So it's like Dutch Harbor, yeah?
About like that, yeah.
But then you're not staying overnight.
No, hope not. Got lots to do the next day. More flying.
Yeah.
You'll mess up your check ride if I do that.
Well, if you decide to spend the night.
Yeah.
Lighting.
Oh yeah, that was my job.
Oh. Oh, I'll come with you.
Final farewell.
Yeah.
Of the Electra.